Good morning, afternoon, and evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Zachary Nolan.
And my name is Carter Nolan.
And we are recording at our regular time of 3:06 a.m.
What do you mean? That's earlier than we normally do. Normally, yeah, 3:30.
Yeah, it's 20 minutes early. It's 20 minutes early, and we actually have a lot more energy.
We have a problem.
What?
We have a severe problem.
What?
That we're recording at 3:06.
Needs more cowbell. Anyway, yes. So if you're watching this, if you're looking out, if you're looking for more of our hockey related content, Prairie Podcast episode 6 is dropping on Spotify and on our channel later today. It should be up during the morning,
fantastic.
The proper morning, not this morning. This morning is a sham. And it pretty much is just like, well, we got you know what? Pretty much is it. But yeah, let's talk about this. Carter, what did you think of this episode?
What did I think of this episode?
Yep, that was what I said.
It's good. I'm not sure what you're doing.
I have attachment issues, okay? Get over it. How else will I announce its spoilers to the viewers at home who cannot hear? They will be like children lost in the dark.
They're like, shit, I couldn't hear this guy, but now that he's got a plunger.
A plunger speaks more languages than my mouth could ever use.
Also talks a lot more shit.
You saw that too? I'm glad. Okay, good. So anyway, yeah, this is a fun episode. So without getting into spoiler territory, this is just, it's night. Like, it's suspenseful, but good. It's very small in scale, yet big in ramifications.
Also, all you nerds that like all the little details and Easter eggs and
you're
stuff
one
like
of
this,
them. Don't make it sound like you don't know who the fuck
oh,
they
no,
are.
Oh, no, no. I know I'm one of them. This is an episode for you. This is an episode that has a lot of little things.
But things that have more meaning. Not just saying, oh, look, it's an Amoidian. No, there's not like that. Like, yeah. It's not like, I know what those are. It's like, oh, I know where that's from.
Yeah.
So we have two reactions, right?
They're subtle. I believe so, yeah.
Yeah. Two. So, anyway, with that being said,
I'm not letting you spill these damn drinks.
You've been warned!
That's a spoiler warning, if you didn't say it because you were silent
so,
the whole time.
So, guess who's back? Back again!
Captain.
Rex is back! There's no captain there.
Commander.
let's
yeah, because Cody was definitely above
let's
Rex
demote
the
him,
whole clone
then
war.
Execute him. That's right. I bet they did the same thing to all the other people. You were not general. You were actually admiral-in-chief.
It turns out Pon Krell was a Padawan when he was killed.
Yeah, didn't know that. But yeah, so Rex is back reaction here.
What?
Let's find him first up. That was a weird sounding blaster.
Oh. Yup.
Yes!
It's definitely Rex.
You don't need to say it, but yes.
Who are you? Rex.
Is that the same poncho thingy that was the girl's hat?
Another clone.
And now Carter's thinking, oh,
I didn't even
grab a triangle, yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, I can remember that time.
Yeah, just think of the a minute before 4:20.
Actually, it was 3:16.
Let's
go. It was like 3:16. So
okay, good. I actually hit this button way before it.
What?
So okay. Anyway, but yes, Rex is back, and Rex just looks great. And honestly, just watching this and just seeing, like, not Rebels Rex, because we've been watching a lot. It's just so nice.
Yeah.
I don't hate Rebels Rex. I just, like, watch a man.
Rebels Rex versus Clone Wars Rex. It's
this isn't like goddamn Batman. Just only watch him in his prime, and he's so much better. Like, I love grizzled vets, but like that,
yeah.
That's my Rex.
I wonder if they're ever gonna expand upon that whole thing where it's like Rex is in Return of the Jedi.
Right. I feel like they're gonna do that, but that'll be like an off thing. Like maybe if they're doing it for like the Mandalorian in some facet.
Maybe
they can
the thing is that the new stuff that they're adding stuff in the prequels, adding stuff in between episodes 3 and 4,
and they're not touching the sequels with the 10th
Well, they're
prequel.
Doing stuff between episode 6 in the sequels. But the thing is that there's not much that they actually do that takes place right between 4 and 6. They like to just kind of keep the original story there and just kind of build around that.
Yeah, which is ironic because there's actually a lot of time period. But let's focus on the Bad Batch episodes, shall we? So pretty much just picks up. it pretty much cuts off the inhibitor chip arc at the knees, which is good in some ways, but really, really, really goddamn annoying. Because where the fuck? We're finally gonna see the Empire next episode. Because literally,
it's about damn.
Like first
time.
Off. What's the planet they went on? It's Cal Kestis's planet,
Braca.
We think.
Braca.
Action here.
It's who's defense?
Rexus.
Oh my Christ.
Braca.
Where do I know that?
What is this place?
Is that the place that Cal Kestis is?
The Starship Graveyard. I'll pick it up.
Yeah, that's from Fallen Order. Yeah, you can see the Venators.
I'm gonna be Cal.
But yeah, like... It's just good to see that part, honestly.
Yeah, this is... It's funny because, like, when we watch this... When we watch The Bad Batch, there are some bridges that you know that are going to be built and they're going to cross. This is not one I expected. I didn't expect Fallen Order to get any sort of mention in any way. And...
Actually, Force Awakens.
And... What?
The creature.
Oh, yeah, I mentioned that, yeah. The creature that, the... octopus like thing is the same
probably like the ninth octopus like creature.
Yeah, it's the same creature that you see in The Force Awakens that's tearing through the ship and it's like suck on
the
Millennium
the
Falcon
yeah.
and making a mess out of Han Solo.
Yeah, like honestly this episode's funny. This episode for me was frustrating a tiny tad bit and not because I wanted to see more than one. I can't tell you. They're just blue-balling this goddamn Imperial arc, and I'm not standing for it!
Yeah, they, if we...
Tell me about Kamino, damn it!
Yeah, this is,
We got... I want more war crimes!
Yeah.
What a sentence!
War crimes bring these ratings.
Yes. War crimes is for wonderful moments.
Now, here's the question. Do you think...
Oh...
Do you think that they try to get Crosshair back?
Yeah, of course they do. They're good people. They're the fucking protagonists. Of course they'll try. They're going to fail.
You think that they're going to fail and Crosshair is going to stay Imperial?
Crosshair's whole character...
Are we going to get to see Imperial Cody?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Of course
we
will. We
have to get...
That Imperial has to Cody. Be it. That has to be one of our game plans here, but like...
And one
Crosshair
thing I will say, though...
Crosshair was designed to be cold-hearted, so...
Cody, you cannot... You can't have them take the chip out. He's got to stay Empire.
Cody has to go down with the ship.
Yeah.
Cody needs to go down with the ship, and you know who's got to pull the trigger, right?
Rex.
It has to be Rex.
Oh, my God.
It has to be Rex. And then you can have the flashbacks hitting them as they're fighting. You know what it needs to be?
Oh,
this
my
fight
God.
Needs to take
they
place on
this,
a Star Destroyer.
They could... This could... Oh, my
or
goodness.
A Venator.
If
or,
that's what we get, which I think we will, that is going to be so good and so goddamn emotional. Oh, my God. What is it with the Clone Wars and everything branching off of that? That just makes me want to cry my eyes out.
That's what war does. That's what war crimes is. What did I say? Don't blue ball my war crimes. Can we make a shirt out of that? Don't blue ball my war crimes. I feel like it would be taken out of context.
I don't even...
That's our merch designs.
It's 3 a.m.
Don't blue ball
it's
my war crimes.
Just stop it.
But yeah, Wrecker also has his moment of being an asshole.
And a child.
Yeah. Well, Wrecker's a child as a whole. He's just always looking for affection. Freud would have a fucking field day.
I think we forget that these clones grow up twice as fast as any normal human.
You know, not emotionally.
Like, they'll be like 5 years old and they'll look...
Yeah,
like
honestly,
it'll be like 10 years
old. I know
old
what you're saying.
It'll be
I know
a fully
saying.
Grown adult.
Right. What do you think of this episode overall? Was it good?
Oh, for sure. Yeah, this was a
like,
good
like, honestly, guys.
This doesn't feel like filler. This actually has
we're not gonna
story
go,
relevance.
We're
to
almost
it.
Done. We're probably done this review because, honestly, like, if you guys have any questions, we'll answer them in the comment section because please tell us what you thought of this. If you're new to the channel, welcome.
Yes.
Please hit the subscribe button because we're actually really close to 500 subscribers and it's very exciting because that's our goal. I guess by the end of the month, but you know what? I think we've gotten to that point. We can be optimistic that we can get past it by the end of the month.
Yeah.
Which is great to see, because this has gotten a lot more attraction
now,
than we thought it would.
I'm going to be curious how this is going to go now that the hockey content is still going to be there, but, I mean, the Jets aren't playing, so.
Yeah, we have our Priory Puck podcast. We also have a No One Hockey podcast episode. We have a couple in the works. We have the one on Department of Player Safety,
I'll do it.
Yeah, I know.
We're both
you and I will do it. We're going to cover it a little things. It's not going to be like a whole, like, rant. It's more or less of, like, just tell us what you do.
What can be
anyway,
done?
Anyway, not now. But, I know, Carter, I know. Don't worry. You're doing well. But also, too, there's Bad Batch. No Mighty Ducks now. Book of Boba Fett's a long run way away.
Once we get more time, maybe Rebels Season 3?
We'll probably review the two semifinals matchups, or at least in their conclusion, and then we're going to definitely cover every single game of the finals, because that's fun.
Oh, it's a Stanley Cup finals.
Actually, too,
you have to.
For the finals, you and I will do reactions for that.
Yeah.
I'm telling you that right now.
Like a Jets
game. And then
game.
We have, our Jets game reaction compilations coming up, which will take a long time, because we have to watch every single footage of me talking, and that is a chore. But yeah, thank you for watching.
You know what? I agree with that.
Yeah, you say that like you don't sleep 15 hours a day, mo guy.
Yeah, you know, it happens.
Okay, thank you for watching, and don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, comment down below your thoughts on this episode, your thoughts on the series, your thoughts on this video, your thoughts on the entire show as a whole.
Yes.
Because we answer literally everyone.
Yep.
Follow us on Instagram at Normal Hockey Podcast. Thank you for watching. We will see you next time. Yay. Good soldiers follow orders. Hit the button.